Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in today's session we are going to study the structure of natural rubber. Natural rubber is the rubber which is not synthesized but obtained through certain trees. Now this rubber is taken and collected and then we later studied the structure of it. So in today's session we are exactly going to study the chemical formula and the structure of natural rubber. Structure of natural rubber. Natural rubber is cis polyisoprene. Now first let me explain you this. What is cis polyisoprene? Now there are two types of isomers. One is cis and one is trans. When I say cis, like for example, let us see in the structure over here. Now cis and trans are two types of isomers. When I say cis, let us look at the structure over here. I have double bond over here, C double bond C. On below this, over here, I have CH2 and CH2 attached to it. That means both the CH2s are attached on the same side, that is below the C double bond C. It can either be on the opposite sides. If it is on the opposite sides, then it is known as trans. But opposite sides of what? Opposite sides of this C double bond C. So if I had a CH2 here and here, that would have been trans. Since both the CH2s are on the same side, it is known as cis. Polyisoprene. Poly means many and isoprene. Now why have I used isoprene? Because I'm getting an iso structure over here. This C double bond C is over here, but this CH3 and this CH2 are getting iso structure, giving me an iso look to it, and that's the reason why I have cis polyisoprene, which can be represented as this is the entire structure of my rubber. Let us have a look at it. I have C double bond C. I have made dashes over here, dashed lines over here, which can actually give us a look of different monomers combining together as a polymer. That means rubber is a polymer. Polymers are nothing but structures which are made from different monomers. And what are monomers? Monomers are macromolecules or some complex kind of molecules. So over here, I have made a structure of rubber which is a polymer and I have shown three monomers of it. Where are my three monomers? The first one is here. The second one is here. And the third one is here. So what is happening over here? These three monomers are combining together to form the polymer, which is my natural rubber. Let us discuss one monomer distinctively. All the three monomers are the same. So over here I have C double bond C to this. At the cis positions I have CH2, CH2 attached to it. Over here on the top I have CH3 and this is an H over here. What happens is this CH2 will get attached over here. Now if you all see over here below C double bond C, that is below, I had both the things attached. But in my next monomer, it's above C double bond C, above, I have both the groups attached. So over here for the first monomer, I have CH2, CH2 in the cis format below C double bond C. Over here, I have CH2, CH2 in the cis format above C double bond C. But over here, because of both the things, this will not change. That means, so even though I have CH2, CH2 below C double bond C or CH2, CH2 above C double bond C, that will not make a difference. What makes a compound a cis compound? The only condition is both the groups should be on one side. It can be either below or above. Over here for my third monomer, again, both the groups are going below it. See, both the CH2, CH2s are going below C double bond C. That does not make a difference. Why? Because both of them are at the same side. If both of them were at the opposite side, they will be named as trans. Since both of them are in the same side, they are being named as cis. So this is my cis polyisoprene. Being cis formed, the polymer develops coiled structure and hence possesses elasticity. Always my rubbers are elastic. Now why are they elastic? Because all these bonds which are between them are in a coiled structure. And because of that coiled structure, when you try to pull it, it gets pulled like a spring. Molecular weight ranges from 1 lakhs to 5 lakhs. Now let us actually see the coiled structure of it. Natural rubber can also be represented in a coiled form. This is exactly the same what I had drawn in the previous page, but over here it is in the coiled format. Now what happens over here? I have C double bond C. Now this C double bond C also has an H attachment to it. This is CH3 and this is CH2 over here and this is CH2 over here. This is the previous version of it. What was happening? C double bond C and H was over here. In the coiled form, this H is not written distinctly. It is just attached with the C. And below that, I have CH2, CH2 and above that, I have CH3. So I have C double bond C, this H is attached to it. Below that there was CH2, the below CH2 has come over here, the another below CH2 has come over here, and the above CH3 was there, it is over here. C double bond C, H which was over here is now here. CH3 as it is, and this CH2 and this CH2 are like that. Now if you see, this is the entire structure from here to here. This was one monomer. The second monomer starts from here. If you see again, I have CHC. This entire part is been replicated over here. This what I have drawn over here is been replicated from here to here. This part is similar to this part. Why? Because it is the same monomer. The monomers keep on repeating themselves. So this is one monomer, this is one monomer over here. I have one more monomer over here. I have one more monomer, and these monomers are just coiled together in the form of a spring. Now because they are in the form of a spring, what happens is when I stretch them, they get stretched. When I leave them, they get leaved and come to the proper position which they had. And because of this, rubber possesses the property of elasticity. Again, we'll see one more monomer. C double bond C, the H is over here, CH3 on the top, CH2 which was down in the cis position is here, CH2 which was down in the cis position is here. Similarly, C double bond C, this is my CH3, CH2 which was down in the cis position is here, CH2 which was down in the cis position is here. This is my third monomer. In the same way, these are also my different monomers, and all these monomers coil up together to form the proper polymer of mine, which is my natural rubber. So over here, this is the coil structure of it. But always remember, this structure is also in its cis format. Why it is in the cis format? Because this CH2 was below, this CH2 was below. They have just turned their shapes and turned over here. That doesn't mean that the cis comes to trans. Over here I have CH2, over here on the same side I am having CH2. It is not that the CH2 has gone on a different side, and that is the reason why even in the coil structure, the natural rubber will remain in its cis form. So here in this video, we studied what exactly is natural rubber, the structure of it, the cis form or the cis isomer of it, and also the coiled form of the natural rubber. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.